It's Power 105.1 is the Breakfast Club. We got a special guest hanging out with us today.
From the squad, Brick Squad.
That's right. Scooter.
Young Scooter.
What's going on with it?
What's going on, sir?
NYC.
Everything cold good? Weather, it's cold traffic. Up here.
You used to New York, man?
Nah, the traffic crazy, man.
This ain't your first time here, though, is it?
Nah. Okay,
traffic is bad in Atlanta, too, though.
Nah, it ain't bad. Y'all finna kill each other up here.
Oh, yeah?
Now you're doing 100 downtown alone.
You can't. Not even a little bit.
Charlamagne excited. Go ahead. Say what you're going to say.
No, I'm saying he's from Walterboro, South Carolina. You know I'm from South Carolina. You know I'm from Mounts Corner. So you know, why did you move from SC to ATL?
The country, them dirt roads. You don't see nothing.
Exactly.
So the same reason you moved.
You're damn right.
18 years ago, you don't see nothing. Mm.
Do you ever go back?
Yeah, I go back all the time.
You know, it's a lot of rappers in South Carolina putting in work. They like to know one of their own is out here prospering. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Now I want to ask you something, Young Scooter. We had a big debate earlier about tricking. What is tricking exactly? Now, Charlamagne and Envy differed on this, but...
let me go ahead. I'm going to tell you my definition.
Charlamagne thinks tricking is anytime you spend money.
Anytime. You buy a girl a flight, you fly a girl out some way.
You trick.
Exactly.
I don't think that's tricking.
What
I
about
think tricking,
cab fares?
You doing that to do what?
See, you're a banger.
I think tricking is it's going to sound crazy, anything to make her feel good. So if it's a cab ride... That doesn't make her feel good.
Yes, it does.
Yes, it does, especially if she don't got the money to pay for that cab.
If you to come to your house, you tricking.
Because look, you could tell
what you're going to do.
Absolutely.
That's right, and you could tell her, you got to figure out how to get here if you want to see me. So, or you could say, listen, baby, I ain't going to have you on the train trying to catch a ride. Let me pay for your cab. That's tricking.
Exactly. What if she don't got no money to get there? You know how that good that's going to make her feel that you paid for her cab?
$8.
And a flight is definitely tricky.
Think about $200. Most of the girls, most of the guys a girl mess with probably don't pay for a cab.
Most girls trick, though.
Most girls trick?
Women, whatever it is, 90% of them.
So women trick on
95.
You?
95. They trick on everybody.
What's the most you ever had to spend? Whether you gave a cash directly or indirectly. What's the most expensive gift you bought or the most money you gave out for some box?
$1,000.
$1,000, what was that for?
That ain't bad.
Everything.
How much you get in the show now? About 8, 9, 10?
I get 15,000.
Oh, yeah, so a stack ain't nothing. You good.
Now, how did you get signed? Let's talk about your deal.
I got no deal.
No deal.
Whoa.
No. So, you saying you signed a Gucci?
No, I got no deal.
Oh, so you signed nobody. You free.
No
free at last,
deal.
Free at last.
Yeah.
You're not even with Brick Squad?
Yeah, I'm Brick Squad affiliated. Free bands affiliated as well. They're just big brothers to me.
Oh, okay. There's no paperwork.
So what's the plan right now since you're independent? Because you're totally independent.
Yeah, totally independent. Mm-hmm.
You got a big record with that Columbia, man.
I'm dropping the album like July.
You'll keep it independent?
Yeah.
Mm. So how'd you get down at Bricks? Why, you was one of Gucci shooters or something in the street when you moved ATL? Came from South Carolina, had to put in some work?
Nah, ain't like that. That my boy, though. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So now he just want the best for me, that's all.
So now with no deal, you just recently put out the remix.
Yeah.
And you got Gucci on there, you got Ross on there. Now explain your affiliation with all these dudes.
You got songs with Future, you got Drummer Boy producing.
Well, like these are not no easy things.
Yeah, Gucci, he introduced me to Bird, man. Mm-hmm. So I salute him for that. But as far as the remix, a lot of people want to get on the song because the title, the topic, and the beat so crazy. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's what made everybody just want to jump on it. But I just chose to put Ross, Bird, man, and Gucci on it because they're the street.
Right. What's the relationship with Birdman? Because I see him in the video. Like, I thought, okay, is he on Cash Money?
I kick it with Bird all the time.
Now, you know Birdman trying to get him on Cash Money, though. I'm so sure.
A lot of work together. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he rich gang. You know I'm a rich gang affiliate. Mm-hmm. Just got to stay down Bird, man.
Birdman be ready to cut that check, too. He's ready to cut the check.
I tell him, he'll do it. Hey, anything. Like, I could tell him right now, do this, he's going to do it.
He ain't pressing you like, look at Bird, boy. Nothing. You got to sign
he
this
whatever I'm with.
Wow.
That's dope.
Mm-hmm. Now, have you ever really been to Columbia? Not South Carolina, but the actual Columbia in the
record. I'm a convicted felon. I can't go nowhere.
You on probation parole now?
Yeah.
For what?
They know you here?
Nah.
Oh, stop it.
That ain't going to turn out well, man.
I ain't got but 8 months left.
Oh, yeah, so far. But what are you on probation for?
I don't want to talk about
it. You ain't got nothing on your ankle, do you?
It's done and over with now, right?
Trafficking.
Trafficking.
Oh, you might have just left Columbia for real. You ain't got nothing on your ankle, do you?
Nah.
Man, they might violate you after they see this. Matter of fact, we shooting this in Atlanta. This is in Atlanta.
We're on location.
We're in the Atlanta studio.
This ain't New York. We're shooting this on location.
Unless he was charged in South Carolina, then we had to do it from South Carolina.
Yeah.
Eight more months.
So I don't want to be the cause for anybody to get...
Oh, no, there ain't nothing like that.
Now, I saw you on Vlad TV commenting on the death of Slim Duncan, rest in peace. You know, the guy that killed him, got sentenced to 25 years in prison. You said that was the best thing for him.
Yeah, I think. anybody who kills somebody, you know, some problems coming behind. Mm. Ain't just him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He got skins in these streets. Scooter still talk like he a drug dealer. He don't really want to say too much. My album coming out July. You know,
I ain't got no choice.
Man, I ain't really got too much to say.
The rap gang like the streets anyway. All the rappers want to be in the streets, so ain't no difference.
That's not a good thing, though.
It ain't.
Nah. I mean, only reason it's not a good thing.
A lot of problems in the streets.
Yeah. Who want to be in the streets? Honestly, you come from the streets for real.
I'd rather play basketball.
That's why you rapping, so you don't got to be there no more.
Yeah, that's right. Trying to rap my way out of.
Now, when you're in this industry and you see all these dudes that talk about a lot of the stuff that you live, how does that make you feel?
It don't make me feel no type of way. It's just they need to feel the type of way. You misguiding the people. Mm-hmm. You don't want nobody to buy into your music. Or you like fans buying to you. They just listen to your whole story.
That's
and you
70% of the industry, though.
And then you lying. But it's an entertainment business, so I can't really say nothing.
Do you feel like once you start getting successful, people start trying to put pressure on you? Like,
yeah, all
a lot
the
of people,
time.
People coming around you, trying to get jobs and get money and all of that.
Yeah, B.I.G. said it best. Money bring problems. More money, more problems. Mm-hmm. It come with it.
Because I always hear about problems like that in Atlanta, especially. With people trying to extort people.
Because the music, so many folks rapping in Atlanta. Everybody in Atlanta rap. Girls and everybody rap. Mm-hmm. So it like that.
Mm-hmm. Now, with the industry that you were in, as far as we'll say allegedly, your trafficking.
He just left Columbia.
Now, a lot of people will glorify all the stuff that they've been as. Now, with your album, are you glorifying what you did? You know, do you feel sorry for what you did? Would you ever do it again?
Envy just got saved, so he might be judging you a little bit.
I'm just asking the man a question.
You say like on my album,
are you glorifying what you did, or are you talking about changing?
If you listen to my music, I'm rapping my whole story. Mm-hmm. If you pay attention, like a lot of people say, like
that's a sale.
Yeah, God.
Stop it.
It's a sale. But go ahead.
Yeah, I do that though. Like, you gotta do that though. Mm-hmm. That would make people feel you, because there's a lot of people that have been through what I done been through. Right. So I gotta rap about it.
Now, would you ever do it again? If you lost it all and the rap wouldn't work, would you go back to it?
You ain't got no choice. What you gonna do? Die. You, money run the world, so you gotta get some
you
money.
You were supposed to say, of course not.
You supposed to say, of course not. I get a regular job.
You ain't gonna never get nobody. Listen, ain't nobody from Brickswalk gonna ever talk sideways.
Nobody is finna get no regular job. I know you can't get a regular job in Atlanta.
You know how stupid you would look? You know how stupid you would look working a regular job after being young Scooter the rapper?
I can't go nowhere but the street.
Come on, man.
Go in a grocery store. No.
You got them shades on while you bagging groceries. With that nice roll.
You better keep the truth.
Come on, man.
Jeremy, stop hyping it up.
It's the truth, though. It's bad for rappers because they can't never go backwards. We'll clown them. Hey, you know Scooter work in Walmart now.
Just like we did a meal.
He don't even know who that is. You know who a meal is?
See? Rockefeller.
Yeah.
I know that.
Where she at? She work at Walmart in North Carolina.
Does she really, or is that a rumor?
That's what I heard.
Yeah, that's what they said. She worked at Walmart.
We got to get the address and get up there, man.
Man, she's the undone. No, so what you feel about the ATL rap scene?
It's crazy. Like, every night, Atlanta don't stop. Like, from the club opening to the morning, it's open. So every night, it's a party. Atlanta turned up all week.
So you say you down with Free Bands too? So that's Future Squad, right?
Yeah.
So he's helping executive produce your album, maybe.
He just helped me with everything, like the music, just give me guidance. Mm-hmm. Hey man, Gucci, they just like big brothers, just want to see me win. So that's why they just stand behind me like that.
That's dope.
Nah, Scooter, you done put in some work in these streets. All these people ain't affiliated with you for no reason. Either you got real good prices or you done caught some bodies.
You gotta do your research on your
stuff.
A lot of rappers get like rapping, then they get exposed. You really ain't gonna hear nobody say nothing about me.
Mm. What about Young Scooter? You said the type of music that you do is count music.
Yeah, I make count music because I just like money. Mm-hmm. But a lot of folks be like, man, what the hell are you talking about? Like, what are you? Mm. They don't get it. But if you ain't from the streets, you ain't gonna understand my music anyway. Mm. You gotta be from the street.
What's your process when you record? Do you write?
No, I don't write.
You just go in there and swag it out?
10 minutes, 10-15 minutes. Mm-hmm. You can't write in the studio with the people I'm around. You can't even write. You just got to go in. Ain't no writing.
Somebody on Worldstar right now. See, that's why I don't like him right there, because he don't write his own lyrics. That's gonna be the world's upcoming.
Write, I just did something with Wyclef last night. He didn't write nothing.
Yeah, I see you doing. How you meet Clef?
At Cyrus, the radio XM.
Serious?
Okay, yeah.
I met him out there.
So you got Clef on your album too?
Yeah, I'm gonna put that one on there. I'm gonna hold
Clef,
that one.
Clef working. Clef wanna touch everybody. Pause.
He gave me a banger. Yeah. His beats crazy though. He got the best beats in the game. I done heard. Mm. Yeah.
So no labels coming at you like, all right, Scooter, you ain't putting that out independent.
All of them. I just chose not to deal with them.
At all. So you hell bent on dropping your album independent in July.
Yeah, got to July 2nd. That's a must.
Well, it's Young Scooter, ladies and gentlemen. We appreciate you stopping by.
Yes,
appreciate that.
And next time the album comes out, you know you got to stop by again.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm going to come back before then.
And please, Mr. Probation Officer, we shooting this in Atlanta, so don't violate them.
Yeah, this is 105.1 on Peachtree Road.
Peachtree Road.
We're on Peachtree right now.